The question says, a disk of moment of inertia 0.5 kg meter square rotates at 5 revolutions per second in a horizontal plane about a vertical axis through its center of mass. A trickle of sand falls on the disk at a distance of 0.8 meter from the axis and builds a 0.8 meter radius ring of sand on it. If the speed of the disk decreases to 4 revolutions per second, the quantity of sand that has fallen on it is. Now practically we can say this is the disk for which the moment of inertia is given as 0.5 kg meter square and it is rotating, let's call it as N1, and as 5 RPS. Now on this the sand falls forming a ring away at a distance of 0.8 meter. So we can say because of the sand the rotations or the speed of rotation decreases to 4 RPS. So again we can use something called as law of conservation of angular momentum, which is nothing but I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. I1 is the moment of inertia of this disk without the presence of the sand. I2 is the moment of inertia of the disk along with sand. Omega 1 is the initial angular velocity and omega 2 is the final angular velocity, which means I1 is going to be I, which is 0.5. Omega 1 is going to be 2 pi N1. So it is going to be 2 pi into N1 as 5. I2 is the moment of inertia of the disk plus the ring made up of sand. So that is going to be 0.5 plus mass of the sand into the radius square into omega 2 is 2 pi N2 where N2 is 4. So it is going to be 2 pi into 4, which means 2 pi can be cancelled. 0.5 into 5 becomes 2.5, which is equal to 4 into 0.5 is 2 plus 4 mR square. Now 2.5 minus 2 is 0.5, which is equal to 4m into the radius over here is 0.8 meter, the square of which will be 0.64. That means the mass is going to be equal to 0.5 upon 0.64 into 4 is going to be 2.56. Now that can be written as 5 upon 25 by 6, which is approximately 1 upon 5.1, which is somewhere close to 0.2 kg. Now the closest option we have in the option is 0.19 kg. And that is the final answer.